thank you all for joining us for this, our 33rd annual gala. It's hard to believe we've been doing it for that long. We're so appreciative to have so many people here with us tonight, and folks that will honor our first responders as we raise funds for their beloved families. I see so many familiar faces here tonight, and some new ones, and that's what we need. To each of you, thank you for making this a very successful evening. There is one face, however, that is noticeably missing tonight, and his absence is greatly felt by all, particularly me. Our friend and founder, Daniel Rusty Staub, passed away earlier this year. For more than 30 years, Rusty dedicated his life to helping others. He worked tirelessly on behalf of widows, widowers, and children of the New York City's fallen heroes. Tonight, we dedicate this evening's gala to him, and together, we pledge to continue the work he started over three decades ago to make a difference. To begin this evening, I'd like to introduce Julian Davis. Julian's father, Port Authority Police Officer Clinton Davis, made the ultimate sacrifice in the line of duty on September 11th, 2001. We are honored to have Julian with us this evening to sing the national anthem. Julian?
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Thank you, Julian. That was extraordinary. I'm sure your dad is very proud of you and with you tonight. The final words of our national anthem, the home of the brave, are especially bittersweet this year. In 2018, we tragically lost three of New York's bravest in the line of duty. FDNY firefighter Michael Davidson, FDNY Lieutenant Christopher Raguso, FDNY Fire Marshal Christopher Tripp Zanettis. These brave men left behind six young children, two wives, and countless loved ones who continue to mourn them. These heroes put themselves in harm's way and made the ultimate sacrifice to ensure the safety of others. Their heroism and the heroism of all our fallen first responders is why we're all here tonight, as we have been for 33 years. Please join me in observing a moment of silence in memory of Firefighter Davidson, Lieutenant Raguso, Fire Marshal Zanettis, and our founder, Rusty Staub. Thank you. Now I'd like to introduce NYPD's Chief Chaplain, Rabbi Dr. Alvin Cass, and FDNY Chaplain Monsignor John Delendick to conduct tonight's blessing. Gentlemen.
Ladies and gentlemen, the famous philosopher Yogi Berra once said, "When you come to a fork in the road, take it." Robert Frost was a bit more thoughtful. In his well-known poem, The Road Not Taken, he imagines himself taking a walk in the forest when he comes to a fork in the road. Naturally, he can only choose one fork, but forever after, he wonders what life would have been like if he had chosen the other fork. Every police officer and every firefighter in this city is so thankful that Rusty Staub took the fork in the road that led to the founding of this police and fire, widow and children's benefit fund. All through the years, Rusty and the indefatigable Steve Danhauser have guided and nurtured this entity until it is the magnificent and glorious source of so much help and blessing to the people of the city of New York. It's galvanized the interest of people like Ed Schuyler, who is such a worthy public servant and now a private servant for city, but whatever he does, he's concerned about people. And his own self-sacrificing labors in behalf of the people of the city of New York have also galvanized our most generous impulses. We're thankful as well to be able to gather here and express our appreciation to all of you for what you have done for all of us and for a way of showing gratitude to the people of this city who give their lives in behalf of all of us. You know that Rusty Staub, for all of his admirable virtues, it must be conceded, was a skeptic. You know that a skeptic is someone who's always doubting. And he probably got this quality because of his contact with police officers and firefighters. No wonder they hear such fanciful excuses for improper behavior that they become skeptics. A Hasid once said to his rabbi, "Why did God create skepticism? After all, it can even lead one to doubt the existence of God." And the rabbi said, "Even skepticism has a role. When a person comes to you for help, don't send him away with the assurance, 'God will help.' No, you must be a skeptic and you must help him yourself. This is a room filled with skeptics. And of course, Rusty was the greatest skeptic of them all. But all of you who are here tonight have performed the greatest miracle that is possible. And that is to show that it is not death, but life, which has the last word. Rusty's passing robbed us of much, but his life left us with more than his death took away. His death cruelly deprived us of some very wonderful and pleasant might-have-beens, but it can take away the has-beens. It can take away all the years and days that we were able to share with him, all of the common joys and adventures, and the kindnesses and love that have been ours. As you get older, you realize that life is about adjusting to loss. But you also learn that you have to put your loss in perspective. And while we'll always feel Rusty's loss, we'll also cherish what he left behind. will cherish this magnificent fund, which has done so much for so many, many people. Mother Teresa once said, "We were put on this earth not to be successful, but to be faithful." Our police officers, our firefighters, our Port Authority police, our emergency service workers, they have been faithful to the people of the city of New York, to Almighty God, and to their mission. And Rusty Staub, whom we are honoring here tonight, lived his life the same way. You know that Casey Stengel, another baseball legend, was once describing the pitching greatness of Vic Rashi. And he said that Rashi pitched here, here, and there, pointing to his arm, his head, and his heart. That's how Rusty Staub lived his life. Here, here, and there. May we do likewise. Amen.
That's a nice crowd. I have to follow you.
All the years in the fire department, I've often had to follow Rabbi Potasnik. And now I come here tonight, I have to follow Rabbi Katz. Okay. So, Heavenly Father, we've gathered together today as one family. So many of us here in this place have lost loved ones in the line of duty, from the police department, from the Port Authority police, from the fire department. But we gather as one today, not so much as a feeling of sadness, but a feeling of gladness that we have each other to hold on to, that we have each other to celebrate with, to have each other to remember the good times and to remember those things that made us one with those we love. Heavenly Father, we ask and send your blessing upon them today as we celebrate together, as we go forth to go home to our families. We pray, of course, for Rusty Staub, who really started all this, who was a member of everyone's family over the past number of years. And we pray and give him thanks for all he has done. And we promise to continue what he has started. Heavenly Father, there are many people today in this city who are ill because of the World Trade Center. We ask that you send out your healing hands to all of them, no matter what department they be part of. But send out your healing hand and let them be restored to their families. We ask you again tonight to remember all those who are working in the police department, in Port Authority, and in the fire department, that you will lead them and guide them safely home to their families in the morning. And we ask this as always, as your loving children, amen.
Yes. Thank you, gentlemen. Please retire the colors.
I have joy.